Ladies and gentlemen,
you're watching Latest TV.
Welcome to Brighton Lights. We're here in our studios at the Latest Music Bar. Today we've got an all music show with all the best music from all the festivals coming up. One, two, the lovely Nick Hollywood. Hi, Nick.
Hi, Val.
Everyone's wondering who you are. I'm going to tell you that you have created something so fresh, it's freshly squeezed. And not only have you done that, but you've also created an amazing club night in Brighton called White Mink. And I think before we carry on with the interview, we're going to have a little taster of the kind of thing you might expect at this night. So take it away, guys. That was amazing. They were amazing. But that was just a tiny snippet of the kind of thing you might get at your amazing club night, White Mink. Tell me something about how it ever started.
It started with a compilation album, White Mink Black Cotton, which was a double album. Thank you very much. Yep. One side 20s and 30s, the other side modern remixes.
Mm-hmm.
Started from there, became a club night.
Tell me a bit more about the record label. When did that happen?
The record label started in 2005. Yeah, it's about remixing vintage sounds. Mm-hmm. So,
and then what possessed you to just throw in loads of, you know,
20s and 30s swing? It hadn't been done. It felt really fresh. I was kind of hearing the odd little tune. I kind of thought, this stuff sounds great. Why hasn't anyone kind of brought it all together?
Mm. And the description, if I said to you, what is White Mink, what would you say?
The sounds and styles of the 1920s and 30s turned upside down and smuggled into the 21st century.
So you've got the record label and you've brought a few
records here.
This is one of those.
This is a couple of the 12 inches. I brought in some of the CDs, the White Mink CDs.
That's a brilliant CD, I've got
Good. Volume 2. Volume 3 is on the way. Volume 3 will be out at the end of the summer.
Brilliant.
The Correspondents, hot new band on Freshly Squeezed.
They're on Freshly Squeezed as well.
Yep.
All right, well, Nick, it's been an absolute pleasure talking to you.
It's been a pleasure talking to
you too. I'm going
to
see you at Meadowlands.
Cool.
I'm going to see you every third Friday of the month at White Mink.
Yep, you are indeed.
And probably see you at the bar later as well.
Cool.
Thanks so much for talking to us and don't stop. Ladies and gentlemen,
you're watching Latest TV.
She sings like an angel that's had a drink or two, said Latest 7. Some may think that she's a fallen angel, but I like to think of her more as a rising star. Take it away, Joe Harman and company.
Feel good lover, looking out the window through the rain, you're tired again. In my dreams, I take away all the pain so you can feel my touch again. Bend me out of time, seeing this other light, and never want anyone more. I'm just a fool that's sure of a lucid thought, and I'm praying that I'll never be caught. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh no, oh no.
Burning down, let them cry. Ladies and gentlemen,
you're watching Latest TV.
Joe, that was absolutely amazing.
Thank you so much.
I've seen you before on TV, but I think when I see you live today, when I see you, it was a lot more emotional. There's a lot of feeling there.
Yeah, well, I like to think so. Yeah.
No, brilliant. A lot of emotion. Brilliant. Yeah, there's definitely a true soul singer inside
Thank you.
I want really to know, nice. I want to know, when did you find out that this was the path that you were going to take?
It took me a while, really. I mean, I went to uni and I did drama and theatre studies. I was an actress for a while and was going to do that. Mm-hmm. I was really into puppetry. I was going to be a puppeteer. And
really?
And then I went to music college in Brighton. I finished my degree and was like,
Didn't
really
you
sure
go travelling first around
yes.
Asia? And I was going to ask you, why yes. did you then come to do BIM?
Well, I went travelling. Before I went away travelling, I'd had my audition mm-hmm. at BIM mm-hmm. and got in. So I went away knowing that I was going to come back and go to BIM.
I think a lot of people in Brighton, a lot of the musicians I know, have either been to BIM or yeah. are on their way to BIM.
Yeah.
And
it's not that cool, is it?
Well, has it changed your life?
Yeah, well, I guess it has because it brought me to Brighton. Mm. I wouldn't have come to Brighton had I not gone to BIM.
And could you leave Brighton now?
I love it here. I really love Brighton.
You and everybody else.
I mean, I've lived in London. I lived in London for 4 years, so I've done the London life thing. And I just really like Brighton, because I'm from Devon originally, and it's a nice cross between the kind of city of London, like there's loads of stuff going on, and the quiet kind of community feel of, you know, the countryside.
When I first met you, I thought you were a pussycat, but then when I saw you on stage tonight, I was blown away.
Yeah.
You're pretty raunchy.
Am I raunchy?
You're wearing knee boots.
I know, I am wearing knee boots.
I suppose you must have started out like most musicians, just kind of doing open mics, this and that. And you must have had
totally.
A whole heap of jobs. And I wanted to ask you,
totally.
Because I'm a songwriter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And I did write a song called I Hate My Job. And I wanted to ask you what your worst job was that you did on your way to doing your dream job.
Oh, God. It's got to be one of the really awful, hideous office jobs of like literally being a temp and going and doing an office job and not being allowed to do anything but like file stuff away.
Because I think
and take staples out of like thousands and thousands of pieces of paper. That was pretty bad. That was quite a low point.
Tell me about your new album.
Yeah. Well, so we released a live album which we recorded last year at the Hideaway in London. But we released that live album in March. Mm-hmm. But the big one is my debut studio album.
Yeah.
So we're working on that at the moment, basically.
And when's
it's
it going to be?
It's just taking time. We don't know. 2016, possibly?
No, we want it soon.
We'll try.
We're
going to try for, you know, the end of this year.
I do hope so. I think you're definitely going
happy.
Down the right roads. And your music is amazing. And you're playing at Meadowlands as well, so I'm going to be seeing you there. We've been talking about Meadowlands with everybody.
Great, you're coming.
So of course I'm coming.
Excellent.
I'll see you there, and I'll probably see you at a million other places in the future as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you
for playing and
Thank
talking
you,
to us here
Thank
at Latest.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. The Brighton Beach Boys pack out their venue in Brighton Festival every single year. And this year, as well as playing the Beach Boys, they're playing their own music. And as a special treat for their fans, they're playing the whole of Abbey Road by the Beatles. We sent Diana Frangi to report.
Tell us about your career.
I've been an actor since the early 80s, acted in various films. I suppose the notable successes of my glittering career were With Nail and I, Wayne's World 2, Crying Game, Star Wars Episode 1. I was a musician earlier on in my life. When I was at school and at college, I used to play in bands and things, and when I became an actor, that became impossible. But then when I moved to Brighton and started listening to live music in pubs, met Steve and Adrian, and they convinced me to form a Beach Boys tribute band. If you should ever leave me, your life would still go on with me. The world could show nothing to me. yeah, once we'd had the rather faintly foolish idea of playing Pet Sounds and Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band live, we started to take a look at how those records were made. They're both made in the studios with orchestras, and so we needed a string quartet. This year we decided to stretch ourselves and play two different shows. So on the Friday night we're doing the Beatles' final album, Abbey Road, and our own original music, Pop Dreams, all of which is written by Glenn Richardson.
Tell me about the new show.
Well, my songs are going to be paired with the Abbey Road section of this new show, where we, in the second half of the show, we'll play all of Abbey Road by the Beatles with all the brass and strings and all that stuff. It's going to be great. And in the first half of it, we're going to be playing songs of mine, some of which go back all the way to the mid-80s.
And so we asked the audience last year what they would like us to do. And we had some paper at the back of the church, and people could write down the records that they wanted us to tackle. And Abbey Road, the Beatles album Abbey Road, came top of the list.
All the lonely people, where do they all come from?
And then on the Saturday night, we're doing Pet Sounds and Sgt. Pepper again. So we're actually working twice as hard as normal this year.
Well, this unbelievably is our 10th anniversary this year, and we're going to be playing a 10th anniversary concert at the Comedia in November. It's been a good 10 years.
Now I'm joined by a man about town. I see him at all the best parties, and he knows all the musicians I know, and probably thousands and thousands more. It's Mark Ead.
Hello,
hi,
Belle.
Mark.
Hello, Belle.
How's it going?
Parties are great.
Yeah.
Musicians are great.
Yeah. And tell me a bit about the Brighton music.
Well, I think it's pretty serious. Brighton's one of the, you know, increasingly important music hubs in Europe. I mean, we've got the Great Escape coming down. Yep. The whole industry just decamps, not just the British industry, but, you know, bring bands in from all over the world.
Yeah.
We've got, I think we've got more bands or artists per square mile than anywhere else in Britain. We've got Shakedown Festival, it's going to be happening in July, which looks good. Mm-hmm. Razor Light and Mark Ronson DJ set. I mean, you swing a cat in St James Street, you take out 20 producers and artists.
Yeah,
you know,
it's true.
Everybody I meet is a musician.
It's true.
So it's really, really, you know, highly creative city.
And now you're involved in Meadowlands.
I am. I've sneaked into that one as well.
How did you do it?
Blackmailed somebody.
That's good.
No, Jeff Hemmings, you might know. Do you know Jeff?
Yeah.
Jeff and I got roped in to help with the PR and promotions, and we wormed our way in there, and we haven't had.
Fabulous.
It's going to be great.
So, know. Meadowlands is a festival that's going to happen
27th, 29th of May, and Bank Holiday weekend.
It's very, very near Brighton.
It's in a fantastic setting, Glyne Place. You been there?
No.
It's next to Glyne. Oh, you'd love it.
It's near Lewis.
Near Lewis, but beautiful, owned by some Viscount.
Uh-huh. So what can we expect at Meadowlands?
A full-on festival experience, which I think the area really needs. We've got four stages, we've got 80 bands, we've got Comedy Tent, John Hegley.
Yep.
Just go on to meadowlandsfestival.com. Mm-hmm. See all the acts, there's too many to mention.
Yeah.
And on the main stage, there's Joe Harman's been on the show.
Mm-hmm.
There's
she's amazing.
Foy Vance, who I love, he's from Dublin. Penguin Cafe, Turin Breaks, Tom McRae, Phantom Limb, who I love from Bristol.
Loads
of bands
of
I love.
Amazing.
It's funny, though, isn't it?
There is something for everybody
something
at
for everyone.
Meadowlands.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I'm looking forward to seeing you there, if I can catch you.
Yeah, well, I'll be backstage having all the parties.
Well, that's where I'll be.
Well, I'll see you there, then.
All right, then.
All right.
All right, see you there.
See you there,
Meadowlands. Thanks very much for talking to us.
Thanks,
Mark Ead.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen. You're watching Latest TV.
Here is a man who needs no introduction. It's Matt Whistler. And he's actually starred in a huge movie, and we're going to take a look right now at the trailer.
And you're not going to make it all the way from Worthing to Brighton, that's for sure.
Well, there'll be gangs of hoodies waiting for you outside the convenience stores. If your batteries run out of this road, you are basically f***ed, mate.
One man Wow, so this is the scooter in question.
Buggy.
So it'll just need charging up every now and then.
One mobility scooter.
What do I do?
Just recess his forwards and back.
Oh, boy! It's actually got a bit of kick in it. Be able to pull a wheelie on that.
One battery.
Probably travelled about a mile so far and ordered the batteries going down slightly. Oh my God, there's a man being sick over there. Violently ill. You wouldn't be able to tell me how to get to Brighton, would you, as well?
Nothing can stop him.
Oh, bugger. It certainly doesn't feel like man and machine in perfect harmony.
An epic adventure.
You'd be lucky to come out of Port Slade alive.
It's that bad.
I think it's that bad.
The drunks will get you.
And I think you might need backup. That's all I can say.
Are you offering?
No.
There he is! That's up his scooter!
Oh my god! Oh, stay away! Leave alone!
The wrong turn.
You might make it to Hove, but I wouldn't. I don't. Can you real?
Matt, good to see you.
And yourself, Val. Thanks for having me along.
You're very welcome. It's a very sinister sort of feeling I'm getting from the trailer. Can you tell me a bit more about sort of where, you know, what we can expect from this film?
Well, this is one of the biggest films in the history of blockbuster movies. We had 30 catering vans, 2 cranes, 37,000 bacon butties, Madonna.
There's a lot of eating going on.
Lots of eating, and millions of boom mics. We had to close off every road between Durrington and Brighton.
Yeah, because you really did travel quite a long way, didn't you? And the film's called...
Well, it's called The Wrong Turn.
The Wrong Turn. So yeah. Did you actually, ironically, when you were making the movie, take any wrong turns?
Well, I mean, the whole thing was scripted out. We had some of the best writers. It was the whole film was purposely made to look like it was one man with one scooter, with one camera, with just a fiver in his pocket and a thin pair of boxer shorts.
Okay. wasn't it just one man, though, that sort of starred?
No, we had the sort of a very strong team. We were given 5 stars in the Fisherman's Weekly.
Yeah. And that's a really well respected and read magazine.
Well, it was a film that was quoted as being a film that works macros.
It's a big industry.
Yeah, it was quite an experience. I mean, we had Goodyear tyres on there, and it was phenomenal. It's going to be a box office hit.
Great. So this box office hit, The Wrong Turn. When can we expect to see this the real cinemas?
The premiere's at the bus shelter near the Duke of York Cinema. We have a small board on there with some white paint, which I licked up the other day. So hopefully...
Okay. That's brilliant. Matt Whistler, thank you very much for...
My pleasure.
...joining us today.
Yeah. You look great.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Mike Weatherly is our MP, but more importantly, he's an Iron Maiden fan. He's even been known to wear his Iron Maiden T-shirt in the House of Commons. Mike and his daughter Becky have been running a competition called Rock the House, and the winning band will literally rock Westminster this year. Take a look.
Welcome to the Rock the House quarterfinals!
I'm Mike Weatherly, MP for Hove and Port Slade, and here we are outside the latest bar in Brighton and Hove, and we're about to do the Hove section of the Battle of the Bands for the national competition Rock the House. Okay, so I'm here with the organiser of tonight's event, Rebecca. How did it come about, Rebecca?
It came about by I just wanted to set up an event to support Rock the House, and we got some applicants to send in their stuff. I just wanted to put on a live show.
Okay, we're inside the venue, Latest Bar, and we're just here with one of the judges.
Well, my name's Cormac Dorian, and tonight what I'm looking for is band with original material, something that can be communicated properly, good musical strength.
My name is Tim Ridger, I work for the Argus, a local newspaper. I'm really looking for enthusiasm, originality.
And here we are with our third of our judges. Would you like to introduce yourself?
My name is David Keithley. I'm a production manager and a lighting designer.
When you say lighting, you've been with some quite famous bands.
I have provided lighting for everybody from Michael Jackson, the Rolling Stones, U2, Madonna.
There we go. So we've got three excellent judges with us tonight, and we're looking forward to a really good evening.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you're watching Latest TV.
Well, that's it. An amazing show again. We've had Brighton Beach Boys, Billie Ray, Joe Harman, Marky, Nick, Hollywood, you name it. We've had them all here tonight. And of course, there'll be more coming up next time. So until then, we'll see you soon.